Hello everyone and welcome to the Arden Report. In today's video, we will be discussing the Palestinian Hamas invasion of Israel. There's a lot to talk about in this video, so let's get started. First off, these icons show where fighting is reported. This city in Israel, Sarat, fighting was reported here. Currently, it's house-to-house combat. It's very dangerous way of fighting. There's fighting reported here along the fields, the road. There's also video footage, as you're seeing right now, of an Israeli tank, and that video footage was geolocated here, and this Israeli tank was destroyed by a drone. Fighting reported in these cities as well. These are pretty big cities in Israel. Fighting is reported here, and fighting is also reported in this area over here. The black is basically where it is basically under Palestinian control 100%. We've gotten reports that the Palestinians control this city over here. However, it's not 100% under their control because the Israelis are very close by and there will be fighting starting very soon there if it has not already started. Over here, we got this place under Palestinian control with this marking where Israeli soldiers were captured. So let's just go to the statistics of what has happened. So basically, first off, Israel has basically declared war on these attackers, these invaders. The strength of these attackers are basically what many people are saying, 1,000 men strong. The Israeli size is unknown. However, it includes Israeli defense forces and Israeli police. An Israeli general, one of the commanders and leaders, Jonathan Steinberg, has been killed. Unfortunately, he was KIA. Also, another major general in the Israeli Defense Force has been taken prisoner. Hamas has captured him. The Palestinians have captured him. The casualties go as followed: 232 Palestinians killed, 1,790 injured, and 20,000 displaced. Now, these are not specifically talking about the units going into Israel to fight. They do include those, but they also are talking about the Palestinians in Palestine, in Gaza, that the Israelis bombed. They fired missiles, and the Palestinian civilians that were killed as well. The Israelis have lost 300 plus killed. This is including military police, but this is also including civilians as well. 1,500 injured, exactly 1,590 injured, and 53 captured. This is including Israeli soldiers. There have been reports of over 35 Israeli soldiers captured, over 30 Israeli police captured, and there are also reports of the Palestinians taking hostages, taking Israelis, soldiers, police, civilians, just whole entire families, and bringing them back to Gaza as hostages. 17 people from Nepal were captured by Hamas, and 7 were injured. So, back to the map. As we can see, Israeli forces all coming. They all counterattacking. The reason why the Palestinians have been able to take so much land, if we actually measure the distance from the start of Gaza to the end over here, which is under complete Palestinian control, it's 6 kilometers. But if we go even further to this city that the Palestinians have claimed to captured, and there's some evidence that they have it under their control, at least for now, that is 22 kilometers. So the reason being, a lot of people are blaming Israel's intelligence and saying Israel should have known this was happening. Their intelligence, Israeli people from Israel have basically blamed this on the intelligence, and that is what intelligence is for. They are supposed to know, but every once in a while, even the greatest intelligence agencies will be caught off guard. This is very similar to the Kharkiv counteroffensive, with the Ukrainians doing this to the Russians. The problem with the Palestinians, they cannot hold these positions. They can go fall. If this were to happen in America, if 10,000 people were just to invade America from Canada, yeah, they would go pretty fall. However, they would not be able to hold their positions. And once the Israeli counterattack happens, you are going to see a complete change. The Palestinians are going to be completely defeated, and Israel will regain their territory, all their territory, if they do not gain more than that, if the Israelis decide to invade Gaza. Now let's look at the world's response to this. Obviously, the United States, United Kingdom, France, and most of the West has condemned these attacks. President Biden has said that he stands completely with Israel and Israel has a right to defend themselves. Ukraine has said Israel has the right to defend themselves as well and has also condemned these attacks, calling the Hamas and Palestinians terrorists and saying Israel has the complete right to defend itself and basically to recapture what was theirs. Russia, Egypt, Turkey have basically come from the stance of completely stop the fighting. They have not said they're pro-Israel or pro-Palestine or Hamas, but they've told both sides to stop fighting, which is not going to happen because they're basically telling Israel to let this continue, to let the Palestinians keep what they have and just stop fighting, call ceasefire, and that's not going to happen. Iran and Syria have basically, pro-Palestine, Iran, Syria, and Iraq. They're pro what's going on here. Iran has congratulated them for fighting. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching this video. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, join the fact army, and I'll catch you guys on the next video. Bye.